Praise the Lord, people of God. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. I came to talk to you this morning about a prophetic word God has given me. Praise the Lord, God's people. I came to bring you a prophetic word that God has given me, hallelujah, called Even the King. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, by the Holy Spirit, please bless us by your word, with your word, and through your word, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. Praise the Lord again. I want to read to you from 2 Samuel 12, and I want to read to you from the 18th verse. And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died, and the servants of David feared to tell him that the child was dead. For they said, behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him, and he would not hearken unto our voice. How will he then vex himself if we tell him that the child is dead? I'm bringing you a prophetic word called Even the King. We're living in a day and time now where people do whatever they want to do. They ignore God and they do everything their way. But God today is calling for obedient people to do things by His will, His way, and for everyone to do His work. Glory to God. Now, David was a great king. And yes, he was beloved by God. Hallelujah. That's the reason why David did not die when he sinned. Glory to God. Now, David knew the ways of the Lord. He knew what to do and what not to do. Glory to God. He knew because he served under a king, Saul. Now, Saul was a king that God did not choose. The people chose Saul because they just wanted themselves a king. They wanted someone who they could worship. They wanted someone over them. They wanted someone to rule over them when they already had God to rule over them. Praise the name of the Lord. But the people wanted a king. They always do. They always want somebody to worship instead of God. And so God allowed Saul to be king and appointed him king. Glory to God. And Saul used David to fight his wars. And Saul never obeyed God the way he was supposed to. And when it was time for him to be replaced with David, he got angry. He went to a witch. Hallelujah. She claimed to raise Samuel and told him that he would remain king. Glory to God. But it wasn't the truth. And because Saul did this, he and his children, his whole family, died. God killed them. Hallelujah. Even the ones who loved and protected David. Hallelujah. So David knew the ways of God because he had learned it by watching an appointed king. Oh, glory to God. And David knew not to kill. Hallelujah. And to do what was right. Hallelujah. Especially to the household of faith. Hallelujah. You know why? Because Saul tried to kill David. And when David had come upon Saul in his sleep, David cut a piece, hallelujah, of Saul's garment just to prove to Saul that I could have killed you if I wanted to. But I would not, because David knew not to touch God's anointed and do his prophet no harm. Hallelujah. So David knew what was right, and David knew what was wrong. Hallelujah. So when David, hallelujah, was in his kingdom, already anointed, chosen by God to be king, he looked over and he saw Bathsheba, hallelujah. And he called for her and he lay with her, hallelujah, and she conceived, hallelujah. And when she conceived and told David, hallelujah, David premeditated a plan plan to kill her husband, hallelujah, by sending him on the front line, hallelujah. Now, I want you to think about this. Now, Saul was a king that the people wanted. David was a king that God wanted. But they both did evil in the sight of God. Oh, come on here. And glory to God, David's plan didn't work well. God was giving him many chances, hallelujah, to turn away from his foolishness. But he didn't turn away. And eventually, he got what he wanted. Uriah, hallelujah, died. He was killed in battle because David sent him to the front line. And he took Bathsheba, and he thought he was going to have himself a new life with a new wife and a new baby. But God sent Nathan the prophet, and Nathan prophesied to him. He asked David about, hallelujah, a story, hallelujah, about a person who had done wrong. And David quickly said, oh, that man should be put to death. And Nathan said, that man is you. Isn't it awesome? Isn't it awesome to know what's right about everybody else and don't know what's right about yourself? Isn't that just awesome? Not. It's not awesome at all. Glory to God. And so David went and grabbed a hold to the horns of the altar. Glory to God. And he prayed Psalms prayer, hallelujah, that we have today. Have mercy on me, O God, a sinner. Hallelujah. And he went on and on. And because David repented, he didn't die. But God said the baby will die. The baby will not live. The baby you brought into this foolishness, into this lie, into this evil, that baby will not live. And in 7 days, that baby died. And David was sore. He was sad. He was grieved. But not only that, God said he would have war in his house. And he would have much trouble because he murdered a man. He premeditated it. He didn't just get into something and something happened. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Even Moses murdered a man. Hallelujah. Because he was trying to, hallelujah, fight against the evil that was going on. But David did not need to do that. David was a man of valor. David was a great king, but he decided he was going to murder. He premeditated it. Out of a situation he created himself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He was the king. There was no reason to do that. All he had to do was make a declaration. Hey, that might not have been right either, but guess what? He didn't have to premeditate it. And then he never turned away from it. Glory to God. He could have turned back at any time, but he did not do it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to talk today, hallelujah, about the leaders in the world and how some are chosen by people. And they show themselves to be big fools. And they carry on because in their heart they say there is no God. When you carry on and do wrong and do whatever you want, you are saying in your heart that there is no God. That's what you're saying. You may not say it with your mouth, but that's what you're saying. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So they carry on and they act like fools because they're not chosen by God. They're chosen by people for selfish and hateful and mean reasons. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And then you come upon a king. Hallelujah. A leader. Hallelujah. It just means leader in our day and time. Unless you're in a region where you're actually a king or a queen. Then you're not a king and you're not a queen. You're a leader. Glory to God. And so you have others who are chosen by God, and they still fail to obey God. Hallelujah. They still do it their way after God has chosen them to do a specific work, to do what he asked them to do, they still disobey God and think they're going to win, hallelujah, and be a winner. I keep telling you there is a difference. You can win something or think you're going to win something, hallelujah, and not be the winner. Hallelujah. In today's world, hallelujah, our president, he won by hook and by crook, but he is not the winner. God has exposed him for everything that he is. God has made him lose. God has torn him down. God has shown the whole world what he's been this entire time, his entire life. Glory to God. This should move others, hallelujah, to obey God when God chooses you, hallelujah, in the midst, hallelujah, of one he did not choose, and he shows you just how bad they are, hallelujah, that they're murderers, hallelujah, that they're evil, hallelujah, they hurt children, hallelujah, they hurt people, hallelujah, they discriminate, hallelujah, they're racist, but you still, hallelujah, and go ahead and do things your way. Hallelujah, when you know you have an example of what not to do. Glory to God, glory to God. And God is saying, hallelujah, not just, hallelujah, to the appointed, but he's saying to that which is anointed, you have to do right and you have to obey me. Hallelujah, or the child will die in 7 days. Oh, my Lord, hallelujah. Before I released this message, I preached it 3 or 4 times before God said, do it again. I've got more information for you. I need for you to hear, learn, and understand something else. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And not only, hallelujah, are people doing wrong, but God is upset because the children are being taught wrong. And people say, well, why would God let the baby die like that? Because the baby, hallelujah, came out of evil. And the baby would not have been taught right if the baby had lived. Hallelujah. But God is talking today to people, hallelujah, because your actions are teaching your children how to act and misbehave, hallelujah, how to disobey God, how to go with your feelings, how to be racist, how to be stubborn, how to be picky instead of just doing what God asks you to do. God said it's the curse of Eli. It's the spirit of evil. Where the leaders, where the heads do not teach their children right, and if they don't say what's wrong, their actions show the children and show the whole world how to do wrong. And God is upset, hallelujah, with the world and the church. Look at the children, hallelujah. As soon as something happens, they use it as an excuse, hallelujah. Young children and old children, they use it as an excuse to loot, to steal, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As an excuse to steal, to loot, to destroy, to tear things down, hallelujah, acting like it's right. And how come you don't know where your children are? And how come if they're adults now, they're still not afraid to do wrong, lest they're going to hear from mommy and daddy? It is the curse of Eli on this world, on this generation, on the world and their church. They all act the same. The world make excuses for looking nasty and walking around oversexed, want to have sex with everybody, want to attack everything that's pure, hallelujah, want to get in the bed, men working with men, women working with women, doing dirt together, the abomination. God is not pleased with it. And the church, oh, you make so many excuses for your children. They look worse than ever. Oh, hallelujah, showing all their body. You promote rap music, and we're talking about gangster rap and stuff about murder and selling drugs. And you tell me this is how you tell God this is how you are winning souls to Christ. You are lying. You are selling your children, hallelujah, for money. You have betrayed God for money and fame, hallelujah. And I get tired, hallelujah, of hearing the pastor's children talk about, oh, everybody wants to be perfect. To whom much is given, much is required. I don't see you complaining, hallelujah, when you're spending the tithing money and spending the offering money that you should not be spending. That's another thing your parents taught you wrong about. Uh-huh. Glory to God. And I don't see you complaining about that. But you complaining about living holy. And you're on television talking all the nasty mess that you did. Talking about it's a testimony to help others. That's not teaching a young person to do right. That's telling a young person, do whatever you want. God will forgive you. You will escape and make it. For this, the curse of Eli are on the parents and the children. Hallelujah. And in 7 days, hallelujah, I want you to think about what 7 days mean. It don't mean what you think. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Unless you want to count every 7 days. I tell you, the famine is coming, hallelujah, worse than ever, hallelujah. And I don't know why you can't see the famine, hallelujah. But the curse of Eli, hallelujah, is on the world and the church for failure to teach what is right, for failure to do things God's way. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I told you about Saul and David, and I talked to you about you parents, hallelujah. And I want to keep on talking to the church, hallelujah. You've got to stop. You've got to stop selling God. Every time we hear about you, every time we see you, hallelujah, you're talking about secular music. You're promoting secular, the secular and the world, and who you like in the world, and how you feel about this. And everything you do is for secular. Then you wonder why. They have $200 and $300 billion, and you are still barely making it and have to worry about money after all the years you spent on the road, leaving your children behind, not making sure they're okay. Some of them got molested. Some of them in all kinds of trouble. Some of their minds can't think right because you want to be famous. Some of them are still so sad because you want to be famous. You couldn't just do a concert and then go back home. You couldn't just preach the sermon and go back home. No, it was all about you, and you claim it was all about God. But we know that's what the world does. Oh, they give up everything. They be married 6 and 7 times and doing what they want to do. Hallelujah. And then you go and tell them they're blessed so that they can give you some coins. They can give you some scraps. Hallelujah. And they can help you be what you want to be, not what God wants you to be. Stop telling that lie. The world needs to repent. The church needs to repent. Because the curse of Eli is on this world. Hallelujah. And God's coming after you and that evil thing you bore. Hallelujah. Out of evil. You think you're going to get good out of evil. You don't just have to think about your children. But whatever that is that you bore, hallelujah, and that you brought up out of evil you claim was supposed to be of God, or out of love, hallelujah, pedophilia and every other thing, hallelujah. Oh, that thing is going to get exposed and it's going to die. How do I know? God told David. He said, oh, you did this thing in secret, hallelujah. You thought you were doing it in secret, but I'm going to let all Israel know what you have done. I want to talk to the politicians today who are letting the people starve to death. That's all right. Letting people get thrown out of their houses. You've been doing it forever, hallelujah. God is going to shake up the house. He's going to shake up everything. He's going to stop you. Some of you he's going to throw out and throw out for good. Some of you are going to die lonely and sad, hallelujah, because of what you've done to the people, hallelujah, and their children. And for this, hallelujah, your generation shall be cursed with the curse of Eli. For all of you in uniform who kill, hallelujah, and you know it's not right, the curse of Eli is on you and your children. Every judge, every court, every jail, every prison, whatever you do wrong to the people, hallelujah, the curse of Eli is on you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is not playing. Hallelujah. I tell you, God God is not playing, hallelujah. God wants everybody to get right. And let me tell you about this election. And let me tell you about the government, hallelujah. And let me tell you about the president, hallelujah. You think you're getting away, and you think you're getting by, hallelujah. But the day, hallelujah, that you put the children in cages, and you let them get hurt, molested, and die, hallelujah. That's the day, hallelujah. I told you, you called your own judgment, hallelujah. You caused God to get angry, hallelujah. And for this, hallelujah, the curse of Eli, double 2020, is on you and your family, hallelujah. And I don't care what the false prophet tell you, because Balaam, hallelujah, had enough time, hallelujah, to repent, hallelujah. The angel would have chopped his head off, hallelujah. And God had to speak to him through the donkey, hallelujah, because he refused, hallelujah. And I want to look and tell the false prophet today, hallelujah. You keep on lying, hallelujah, because you're racist, hallelujah, because you're hateful, hallelujah, and you're a hireling, and you're constantly looking for money, hallelujah. Oh, God, hallelujah, cry loud and spare not. I lift up my voice like a trumpet in Zion. I tell God's people, hallelujah, and the house of Jacob, their sins, hallelujah. Glory to God, hallelujah. And God say, hallelujah, false prophet, the curse of Eli is on you and your family, and you can't get away with it, glory to God. Let me tell the government something. You're on Jesus' shoulders, hallelujah. He moved this way and that way, and he tells you what to do. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Every, hallelujah, law, every real law, not those fake laws, are based on the Bible. God created everything and everyone, hallelujah. Everything, hallelujah, that's supposed to be based on righteousness and judgment is based on the Holy Bible and based on God. You have no right doing what you want, saying what you want, doing things the way you want to do it. Everything is supposed to be about God. Glory to God. Everything is supposed to be about God. I don't care what you say. You can say it's too much. You can say holy roller. You can say, oh, that's too much. Who can do that? The Holy Ghost is powerful and can help you do what you need to do. Oh, glory to God. Don't tell God you can't do it. You can do it in Jesus' name, but you refuse to do it in Jesus' name. Even the king has to do what God says do. The appointed king, or the chosen anointed king. Every leader, every parent, everybody has to do things the way God says do it, hallelujah. And I wanna tell the church, stop telling these people, hallelujah, who are in your industry, that they can do whatever they want to and they are of God. Yes, God tells even me to tell some of them they're chosen, but that they have to come out of the world, come out from amongst them and be separate, saith the Lord. It means don't do what they do. And for all of you who claim you're supposed to go in and you're supposed to let your light shine, then do just that. Stop marrying everybody you see. Stop getting pregnant from everybody you see. Stop laying down with everybody you see. Stop going out with everybody you see. You can't be partying and doing all these things. And I'm going to tell you again, the reason why you don't make it high up, because every time, hallelujah, we turn around, you're promoting something else other than gospel. Y'all promote everybody else, because more than God, you believe in the world. Don't tell us you believe in God. You believe in the world. You see all the money and all the fame that the world has, so you go along with them, and you teach your children to go along with them. Let me tell you something. You might say, oh, she's such a holy roller, and I know this, and I know that. No. All my mom did was let her light shine, hallelujah, and teach me what is right, and make sure I did what was right, hallelujah. And if I looked like I was off the road, hallelujah, she got me on that road real quick. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Praise God. Praise God. She got me right back on the road real quick, hallelujah, to make sure I wouldn't go too far. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I let my light shine. And I promote gospel music, Christian music. They're the same. They're the same thing. One's not white and one's black. They're all the same. And I promote gospel music and people of God, hallelujah. And I acknowledge everyone. I honor everyone when they, hallelujah, when honor is due, hallelujah. I don't try to take from anybody because they're not saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. No, but I do, glory to God, I do, hallelujah, what God wants me to do, hallelujah. And that is, hallelujah, live holy, live righteous, and do it God's way. Glory to God, hallelujah. Not my way, but God's way, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The disobedience, the living wrong, and teaching others to do wrong is where the curse comes in. No matter how high you are, even the king, whoever the leader is, whoever the leader of the country is, whoever the leader, hallelujah, of the household is, whoever the leader of the school is, hallelujah, whoever the leader is, hallelujah, God wants us to do it his way, hallelujah. We just can't do things our way. We have got to do it God's way. God is tired of people doing things their way. He wants everybody to do it his way. Glory to God. God is not interested in how you feel about it, glory to God. He is interested in you doing what he says, hallelujah. And I'm going to say this again to the church, because y'all are such dignitaries, and I've done this and I've done that. I want you to know God has sent me to bless you. He hasn't just sent me to give you words, hallelujah, of what you're doing wrong. But he has sent me to bless you many times and give you the love, even though you try to ignore it and say I don't. And think you're having private meetings behind my back and private conversations. And every time God tells me to talk to someone, you go to that person in the world and tell them, you know, for your own benefit. So they'll do a song with you or they'll be friends with you. And then you can say, I know this person, and take pictures or be in an event with them. Every time God sends his prophet, one of you think you slick, hallelujah, for your own benefit, hallelujah. And God is exposing the church, pedophilia, and all of the kind of sexual evils, hallelujah. The stealing, the cheating, the lying, hallelujah. The adultery, the fornication, the abomination of homosexuality. Things the church think it's okay to promote when you know it is wrong. Whether you are Saul or whether you are David, because God is tired of the church of using David as an excuse, especially the men. Let me say this to the men, hallelujah. You don't want to hear from God's prophet, especially because I am a woman. Glory to God. But I am a holy woman, hallelujah. And the power of God rests on me, rests in me. God is in me of a truth, and he uses me to do his will. Hallelujah. And I want you to know, this is a time for the women. The women are going to lead no matter what you say. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And blacks, let me tell this whole world, are going to lead. Hallelujah. It is our time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It is our time. It is black people's time and it is women's time. Hallelujah. So everybody in the world and the church better get on board. If you don't like black people, then go somewhere, because the curse of Eli is on you anyway. Because what you do, you teach your children to do. You hate, they're going to hate too. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, women are going to do God's work and his way. And there is a dividing line. Every person of every color, every race, every creed, every religion who does what is right in the sight of the Most High God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Holy Ghost, in his sight will be blessed, and those who do wrong will be cursed. God is not playing. Even the king has to do what's right. Don't care what your position is. God does not care what your position is. God does not care what you own. He does not care what your title is. He does not care how you look, how you dress, how much money you have. Even the king, the leader, the person appointed to lead anywhere and do anything must be responsible, must be obedient, must do what is right. Hallelujah. Let me tell the presidential candidates one thing. You know that Donald Trump is out of his mind, and God is not pleased with him in any way, shape, or form. He has caused evil to his own family. He does not care about anybody. He doesn't care if you live or die. He does not care. As a matter of fact, it seems like he gets more joy out of your death. Hallelujah. You better pay attention. But let me say this, hallelujah, to the other candidate, hallelujah, who God chose, Biden. God chose him, but he did not choose Kamala. It is not because nobody dislikes her or whatever, but God asked for him to make a statement that the African American whose ancestors suffered slavery, and we are still, hallelujah, feeling the results of that slavery today, to put in a person, hallelujah, Stacey Abrams, hallelujah, take her along with him, hallelujah, and let her be vice president, and hallelujah, get more learning firsthand, hallelujah, and walk her in. But he decided, like most whites do in this country, in America, that he wanted someone, he and his wife, watch out now, he and his wife wanted someone who is more acceptable to whites. And white women and white men got on television and would say, yeah, well, if he picks Kamala, then we'll vote for him. That's what they wanted. It is not because we don't like Kamala or anything like that. She's not prepared. She's not right. She needs to get a lot of things right, her character and everything else. And we're not saying Joe Biden is perfect. God never said that. But what God is doing also with the older people, hallelujah, stop, they're not old, they're older people. They have wisdom. Some of them have wisdom, some don't. But God wants, hallelujah, America, especially white America, the world, especially the white world, to stop throwing the old people, older people, you call them old, God says older, older people away. What is the problem that every time you see an older person, you are full of hate? You hate children, you hate older people, but you love dogs and cats. What is that about? It is time for you to understand that a wise person is better in a position, a wise older person is better in a position than someone who just has, you know, dreams of I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that. Every young person thinks, I'm going to conquer the world, I can do world peace, or whatever other stuff they decide they want to do. But a person with some experience is okay. And we're not saying you have to put in a person their age every single time there's an election. But what God is saying is that you have to do it His way. You cannot do it your way. You cannot abuse the children. You cannot abuse the elderly. You cannot forget about them. You cannot mistreat people, even the king. The one who's not chosen and the one who is chosen has to obey God. And neither have obeyed God completely. One has not obeyed God at all. That's Trump. He has not obeyed God at all. He doesn't care what God has to say. Biden was chosen by God this time, but he did not obey God completely. And I want to thank God for Bloomberg, for Michael Bloomberg, hallelujah, who obeyed, hallelujah, and who got on board, hallelujah. And there is a double blessing for him. Oh, glory to God. And there's a double blessing for all of those who are doing what God asks them to do. Draw nearer to God and He will draw nigh to you. Draw nigh to Him. He will draw nigh to you. You've got to do it God's way. Even the king. I want to press that into your mind. Even the king has to do what is right, or God will step in and do what he needs to do to make sure his will is done and to show you that you will not do things your way and think you are the winner. Hallelujah. You may think you win, but then you have a hard road ahead because you would not do it the way God wanted you to do it. And you have to lose something. Even your life or somebody else's life is lost, or something important, something grave is lost because you would not do what God told you to do. Glory to God. Even the leader, the president, hallelujah, the preacher, the prophet, the parent, hallelujah, the lay person, hallelujah, the teacher, the pastor, the dignitary, the government, everybody in a position who leads has to do what's right so that those coming behind them can do what's right, even the king.